Hi everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in Coronado. This is the 2004 Gemini 105MC. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this vessel has to offer.
Okay, so we're looking at the 2004 Gemini, and you can see, we're starting out the bow here. It has a nice integration of a bow roller, centrally located. Also has a furling mechanism with a double purchase pulley if one were to get a code zero. There is an additional sail for that as well, but you can see it's on a nice self-tacking track up here at the bow. We have the furling head sail and the classic mainsail. This is a double spreader mast. And lots of windows, opening hatches. The boat gets great ventilation, has a nice open feel, especially for its size. So the Gemini 105MC, this particular boat was bought brand new by the current owners, and it's been kept here in San Diego, Coronado ever since. Working our way to the back, you can see this nice davit system here. This is a sailing dinghy. There is a mast for it. You can use a little dinghy and an outboard that comes with it. It does have a solar panel mounted up here. The owner said that it is in operational. But again, this will just show you the possibilities, the capabilities of it. You have a really nice transom entrance way to both starboard and port side. And then as we walk aboard, we have storage here. They have a nice enclosure here for the aft cockpit, but great easy access up to the bow. Lots of handholds here, lots of just places to lounge out and just utilize the space. But if you're looking for a nice comfortable platform, this Gemini definitely does the trick. Storage locker up forward here, anchor locker. Located there, forward bow seats, but great use of space up here. Really comfortable boat. As we walk across the bow, going to the starboard side, gives you a little different perspective of just, again, just its overall design and how they utilize the space here. There are stainless steel racks outboard if you were to get a kayak or stand-up paddleboard. And again, over the helmsman, this plexiglass hatch opens up so you get good visibility of your mainsail. Working our way back aft, swim boarding ladder on this side of the hull. And again, this Kato davit system integrated into this. Centrally located right here, this is access to the backside of the engine. So you can see there's the engine back under here. There are really low engine hours on this. This boat, again, has been lightly used. And then there's the leg drive. It's currently in the water right now. It's a hydraulic leg drive that will actually pick up out of the water as well, too. And then it's a steering pulley system. The cockpit itself is quite nice and inviting. Lots of seating around. Again, when they brought and introduced this isinglass here, it really just encompasses. But as you can see from the straps, this can be rolled up so you have easy access in and out. You get great ventilation. Here at the helm, we have our throttle controls, autopilot, wind, depth, speed, our autopilot wheel mount here, our fuel gauges. We also have voltage, temp, oil, and our tachometer, which is showing 105 hours. Again, great use of space here. Front access to the front side of the engine is located here. And again, overhead, we have these overhead plexiglass doors that open up. All right, as we walk into the salon, we have this really nice door that just opens up out of the way. There's also a drop pin here, so this glass door can slide down so you can have it closed off and but still have the airflow through it. We walk into the salon. We have a bench seat, you know, off to the port side. Here's our electrical panel for our DC, our 110, our Raymarine VHF, our propane fume detector, and our Sony stereo controllers. But again, nice windows looking forward. A little bench countertop off to the starboard side. with some additional shelving, and then our refrigerator with a freezer compartment located here. As you can see, there's still manuals in there. 12 volt outlet, nice large center line dinette table. So a large U-shaped dinette table. This dinette table will drop down and turn into a bed if so desired. First, I'm gonna take you off to the port side of the hull. As we come down, one thing you're gonna notice is just tons of countertop space, lots of storage. There's two steps down, and then looking aft into our one of two aft cabins. This is where they have some fenders, life jackets. This is where the mast is for that sailing dinghy and its sail. Hanging locker storage. The floors are carpeted. And again, lots of space and storage throughout the vessel itself. As we move up forward, this is the head and shower compartment. The shower compartment is quite large. They have a brand new Japsco toilet here. Dehumidifiers everywhere. Again, lots of windows opening and just on the side to let natural light in. We have our sink vanity, cabinets and drawers through here. Again, carpeted floors and our aft facing view. You know, for the size of the vessel, it definitely gives you a lot of real estate. Now coming to the starboard side, we have our linear galley. This is a two burner stove and oven, double stainless steel sinks, large countertop space. And before going forward, I'm going to bring you aft into our twin aft cabin so you can see what this looks like. So really respectable aft cabin, opening hatches, and then there's also a side window port here so you can have that natural light coming in. Hanging locker storage and shelving throughout. That's one thing this boat does not lack is storage. But again, we have the two burner stove and oven, large countertops, you know, integrated drawers here, lots of shelving, countertop space, and overall just a really nice, you know, nice feel to the boat. Moving up forward into the master cabin, we have again tons of shelving, storage throughout. We have an overhead opening hatch. We have these windows forward that let that natural light in. And I would say this is a queen size mattress up here. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you're looking for a smaller catamaran, something that's comfortable, easy to sail, something that would be good for learning or just, you know, taking coastal cruising and just getting out on the water, this Gemini, I think, would make a great addition. So please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel for additional videos like this, I always post my videos prior to, posting the listings online. So you will be up to date with the latest videos. Check the time dates as well. But again, thank you. And I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.